A Road Trip to Sarapiki. Part 2. Birding Spot. Near the top of the rise we stopped. And you should too, at the Cinchona Cafe Colibri. The current structure is rebuilt on what was left after it was destroyed in the earthquake. The family that owns the restaurant has for many years put out hummingbird and fruit feeders, and the spot has become renowned in birding circles. From there we started the long descent to the plains of Sarapiki. The road roughly follows the border between Alajuela and Heredia provinces and the Sarapiki River, which forms in the heights of Poas and gives the area its name. Looming to our right and covering almost all of southern Sarapiki and the Barva volcano is Braulio Carrillo National Park. We continued to drop out of the mountains on the Caribbean slope and entered the La Virgen section of Sarapiki, where the region's first big attraction is located. Rafting and kayaking. The moderate class 3 rapids are ideal for novices and families. This area offers plenty of opportunity for wildlife viewing on the calm stretches between thrilling rapids. There are several operators. Sarapiki Outdoor Center is a good one. If you want to make this the end of your first day in Sarapiki, we can suggest the wonderful Sarapiki's Rainforest Lodge. The next day we continued up through La Virgen and headed toward Puerto Viejo, not to be confused with the Puerto Viejo on the South Caribbean coast. Along the way we stopped at one of the more curious attractions in the area. Dave and Dave's Nature Park. The father and son US expats who own this small reserve have worked it for years, restoring the forests and promoting second-growth forests. They have an interesting story and a tour that is not quite like those you usually find. You sit, you talk, you walk the trails, you drink coffee, and you photograph frogs and birds that you'd have a hard time seeing in other places. It's a quirky and great way to spend a morning. We continued north to Chilimate, where Route 140 ends and Route 4 begins. It has very recently become an even more important intersection with the new Chilimate Vuelta Cooper Highway. Years in the making, it is to be a shortcut for trucks to pass from Limón to the northern border crossing at Los Chiles. It also provides a much faster trip to get to Sarapiki from places like Upala to the west. It had just opened when we were there, but the first rains of the green season caused it to become something closer to the Costa Rica Intercontinental Ship Canal. The drainage issues have reportedly since been corrected. Now heading east on Route 4, we arrived at Puerto Viejo de Sarapiki. The heat quickly made us realize we were not in the mountains anymore. In fact, as far inland as it is, Puerto Viejo is only about 40 meters above sea level. Puerto Viejo is a functional town, not all that shiny or touristy, in the northern plains of Costa Rica. It's hot, flat as a pancake, and filled with pineapple plantations as far as the eye can see looking north and east. The Sarapiki River continues north and empties into the Rio San Juan, the border between Nicaragua and Costa Rica, which spills into the Caribbean. This has made the port a center for shipping bananas and pineapples since colonial times.